Welcome to Sermon Q&A. Pastor Michael here with you. I'm in the studio with Pastor Matt, and on November 14th, 2021, we preached a series on heaven and hell, and this particular sermon was on the new earth. So, Matt, we have a whole bunch of questions that came out of this, but we designed this one just for you.
Quite a few.
I know you love meat, and the question is, will carnivores eat other animals on the new earth?
This is a personal question, because answering it, if the answer is no, that might mean I will not eat meat on the new heaven and earth.
It's plausible.
And I consider myself to be a carnivore, but I do believe the answer is no. We know that there were animals in the garden. We know that there was 100% peace, and we know that a lot changed at the fall, and I think a lot even changed at the time of the flood. So to me, it just makes sense that there would be no meat eating, because that would imply there would be death in the new heavens and new earth. And I think the Bible makes it clear that there won't be death. It makes it clear that there will be peace. Isaiah 11:6-9, there's a really fun verse there. It says, "The wolf shall dwell with the lamb, and the leopard shall lie down with the young goat, the calf and the lion and the fattened calf together." And this is fun. "And a little child shall lead them." Mm-hmm. So as a parent, you would never allow your small child to be with a lion and a leopard and all of that, and then to put a cow there and say, "Hey, let's see what happens."
Yep.
The violence that would ensue. I would never want Weston or Remy to see that. It just makes sense that there won't be any sort of violence like that. And so now that brings me to a lot more questions, though. One, what will we eat?
Yeah.
What is the process of food digestion?
Yep.
There's a lot of implications to the question.
Yeah.
I would love to know your thoughts on.
So here are some of the questions you asked. What did they eat in the garden? Did the lion have canine teeth before the fall?
Right.
Did feces smell? Were there even feces or
That's a
urine?
Big question.
I mean, you went down a pretty.
Will we need bathrooms in heaven?
Is there going to be a sanitation system in the new heaven and the new earth? Or do our bodies perfectly digest? What happens when there's
no waste? Yeah, there's
right.
just, it's
perfect. Or is waste sinful?
I have no idea.
Wow. So do you think that you will eat bacon flavored tofu on the new earth?
No, because that would not be heaven. But goodness, tofu.
I couldn't resist.
No, that's fine.
Is that fair?
Yeah. No, but I think, I mean, you brought up the verse, "No eye shall see, no ear shall hear." We don't even comprehend how great heaven can be. And I'm not saying this is a small question.
Yeah.
I just think when we try to imagine heaven, we think so small.
Yeah.
In that, what are we going to eat? I mean, it will be beyond anything we can think of.
Yep. So one of the, there's a handful of subjects when it comes to sex, when it comes to eating meat, when it comes to marriage, and the Bible has this implication that somehow these things are not going to be on the new earth with resurrected bodies.
Right.
And then we think to ourselves, but these are some of the, our favorite things in the world. And you tell me I can't have a bacon sandwich anymore. And I think what it implies is not so much you're going to be sad, but imagine if heaven is so much better than any of the earthly joys here, then we're thinking too small about how great it's going to be, just to your point.
Yeah.
And so we're sad about these things. And yet when we think about the new earth, it's like, no eye has seen, nor ear heard, nor the heart imagined.
And if we can literally see hell, with the smoke rising and not be sad about that.
Yeah. That's a conundrum in and of itself.
Right.
Yeah.
I don't think we're going to be sad about these other things.
Yep. All right. So here's a question that would come up. What about animals that seem to be created as carnivores? Because for people, particularly for people who believe that there was death before the fall, particularly animal death. So there's a crew of Christians who are going to say the death it's speaking of is actually just humans, but not animal death. And one of the reasons they'll point to that is they'll look at all of the instances of death as a result of sin in the New Testament, and all of them are about humans. Except when you read passages like Isaiah, it implies that now wolves and lambs are they're going to hang out together. One's not going to eat the other. What do you say about people who say hey, listen, there are some animals created to be carnivores. That's just the way God made them. And that's what's going to happen.
Well, one, right after sin, we have the first recorded animal death, which was a sacrifice for clothes, which they didn't need before that. So we'll put, you know, put that on the table. But I don't know that we know what changed at the curse. So if childbirth wasn't going to be painful before the curse, I think a lot of other things could change, because that's a pretty drastic change. And we don't know about the food that was in the garden. I mean, fruits could have, or vegetables or whatever type of food were there, could have the perfect amount of mix of proteins and fats and carbohydrates. And there are vegan people now that, when balanced, eat like very, very healthily. So, it personally doesn't bug me as a, that's going to cause me to doubt God's creation or this. I just think so much changed that,
I mean, imagine a world where there's no death, there's no decay. You're talking about an atomic restructuring of every cell in all of creation, where there's no, you know, second law of thermodynamics, where all things tend towards chaos and disorder and death and dispersion of energy, and all of that goes away. And one of the things that we had talked about in the sermon was, this idea that whatever, like with the serpent, whatever he was before the fall, his state after the fall was devastating, and it was cursed. Before the fall, the serpent was more crafty than the others, was dialoguing. Again, we don't know what that means. We don't know if that was unique because Satan had incarnated the serpent. You know, we don't actually understand that, but there is something about a future glory of animals where we actually don't know how this is going to look when there's an atomic restructuring, and that's nuts to think about.
And it seemed that even before the fall, you know, when Adam was given the task to name all of the animals, there was no mention of, okay, well, I'm going to parade these animals by you, but, oh, you're going to have to be really careful of the lion. You know, it was just, there's the animals.
Hey, T-Rex.
Yeah.
Do you think the T-Rex's arms got smaller after the fall?
Definitely. Yeah. What was that snake that you brought up yesterday?
It was a 50-foot snake, the Titanoboa. Yeah.
Right.
Like, unbelievable. 2,500 pounds, 50 feet long. I mean, it is enormous. Just unbelievably enormous.
Yeah. I would think there would have been some mention of things like that if Adam were afraid of them, but pre-fall, there was no fear. I don't believe there was death.
Well, thank you for that. We are excited to answer more questions about heaven, hell, the new earth, and join us next time on Sermon Q&A.